Hello friend, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 Metric. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_036_DIABM where you save it. You can also download this file on my website. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the Save As button. This will bring the save drawing as dialog box. Rename this file to 00_037_DIABM and click the Save button. Go to the Home tab, Layer Panel and click the Make Current button. Click this 3D wall. Go to the 3D Tools tab, Modeling Panel and click the down arrow under the box and select the Polysolid. Type H and press Enter and type 300 for the height and press Enter. Type W and press Enter and type 150 mm, press Enter. Hold down the Shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit around. At the specified start point prompt, click on this start point. Now move the mouse cursor. We are in the wrong justification. Press Escape to undo the command, to cancel the command. Press Enter to replay the Polysolid command. Type J on your keyboard and press Enter. Change the justification to left. Now hold down the Shift key and the middle mouse button. Start the Polysolid from this point. Continue to click this vertex, this vertex, this corner. Zoom in into this area. Click, press Enter to end the command. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the Move command. At the Select Object prompt, select the Polysolid that you just draw, press Enter. At specifying this point prompt, zoom in and snap into this vertex. At specifying second point prompt, turn on the auto mode. Move the mouse cursor and snap. Use the perpendicular object snap and snap to this point. AutoCAD move the solid into place. Now select this slab, go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the Copy command. At specifying object base point prompt, click anywhere in the drawing, move into the Z direction. Make sure that your auto mode is turned on and type 3000 on your keyboard. Press Enter. Press Escape to get out of the command. Now go to the 3D Tools tab, Solid Edit panel and select the Press Pull command. Click on this area, move the mouse cursor down and type 150 mm, press Enter. Click into this area, move down and type 150 mm, press Enter. Click in this area, move down and type 150, press Enter. Press Escape to get out of the command. Now select this lab, right click, isolate objects. Go to the 3D tool tabs, Solid Edit panel and select the Press Pull command. Click on this face, move and snap into this vertex. Click on this face and move inside. Press Escape to get out of the command. Now right click in the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the Home tab, Layer panel and click the down arrow. Select the cabbage layer. Now go to the Home tab, Draw panel and select the line command. Start the line at this vertex. Move the mouse cursor and use the perpendicular object snap. Snap to this area. Press Escape. Now go to the Home tab, Layer panel and click the freeze command. Freeze this layer. Press Escape. Select this slab and this line. Right click, isolate object. Go to the 3D tool tabs. Now go to the visual style control and select the 2D wireframe. Select this line, go to the 3D tool tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. Move it down to extrude it. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the slice command. Select the solid, press Enter. Type S on your keyboard and press Enter. Select this surface and click on this slab. Select the surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the visual style control and change the visual style to realistic. Now go to the Home tab, Draw panel and select the polyline command. Start a polyline from this vertex to this corner. Press Enter. Start a line from this corner to this corner. select this slab and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Fillet this polyline and this polyline. Now we need to bring the object that we just, the slab that just did this. Type hooks on your keyboard and press enter. When you use this command, AutoCAD brings the most recent delete object. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the press pull command. Press pull this face down to get rid of it. Press escape. Go to the visual style control and select 2D wireframe. Select this 2D polyline and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the visual style control and select realistic. Right click in the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the third layer button. Hold down the shift key to orbit around and see the result. Now we need to subtract this slab from this wall because the slab and this wall intersect. Select the slab, hold down the control plus the shift key, type C on your keyboard, and specify base point prompt. Click on this vertex, the bottom of the ground floor slab. Press escape to deselect the object. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. Select this solid, press enter, and select this slab, press enter. AutoCAD subtract the slab from this solid. To replace the slab, hold down the control and type V on your keyboard. At specifying insertion point prompt, use the endpoint object snapper snap to this vertex. Now, let's grid some windows in this area and this area. To do that, first let's measure the distance. Go to the home tab, utility panel, and select the distance command. At specifying first point prompt, click on this vertex, move the mouse cursor, and snap to this vertex. The distance is 4,703 mm. Press escape to get out of this command. Go to the home tab, drop panel, and select the line command. Hold down the shift key and right click. Select meet between two points. Use the endpoint object and snap to this point. And move the mouse cursor and snap to this point. Now move the mouse, the line into the vertical direction and use the perpendicular object snap to snap. Press escape to get out of the command. Press enter to repeat the line command. Hold down the shift key, right click into drawing area. Meet between two points. Snap from this endpoint and this endpoint. Move the mouse cursor and use the perpendicular object snap and snap. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click the UCS and select the face option. At the select face of solid, surface, or mesh point, hover the mouse cursor into this face. Press enter to accept. Now go to the visual style control and select 2D wireframe. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. At specify offset distance prompt, type 900 mm, press enter. Select this line and offset it to the x-axis, positive x-axis. Select this line and offset it to the negative x-axis. Select this line, offset to the positive x-axis. Select this line and offset it to the negative x-axis. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the 3D tools tab and solid edit panel, click the down arrow and select the copy edge command. Go to the selection panel and click the down arrow, select the edge filter, click on this edge, press enter. At the specifying this point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and click into this area. Move the mouse cursor into the z-axis. Now type 1000 mm, press enter. Select the copy option in the window that appears. At the select edge prompt, select this edge, press enter. At specifying this point prompt, click the endpoint of this line. At the specifying second point prompt, move the mouse cursor, snap into this area, but don't click. Now type 1000 mm, press enter. Press enter to exit the command. Press enter to exit the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. At the specify offset distance prompt, type 1200 mm, press enter. Select select this line and offset it up. Select this line and offset it up. Now go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press Enter. Fillet this line to this line, 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 this line to this line. Press Escape to get out of the command. Go to the 3D Tools tab and change the selection filter back to no filter. Now select this line and this line. Hit Delete on your keyboard. Select this line, this line, this line, and this line, this line, this line. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Copy command. At specifying this point front, zoom in into this area and snap to the bottom vertex of the slab, not the top vertex, but the bottom vertex. Now move the mouse cursor and snap to the vertex of this wall. Press Escape to get out of the command. Go to the Visual Style Control and click down and select Realistic. Now we copy two notes. Hold down the Shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit. Select these 2D lines and hit Delete on your keyboard. Hold down the Shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit. Go to the 3D Tools tab, Solid Edit panel, and select the Press Pull command. At the Select Object or Select Bounded Area prompt, click on this area. Move the mouse cursor inside and type 150 mm. Press Enter. Click on this area. You can also move the mouse cursor outside and type negative distance of -150. Press Enter. Select Move Outside. Type -150. Press Enter. Press Escape to get out of the Press Pull command. Now go to the Visual Style Control and change it to 2D wireframe. Go to the Home tab, Layer panel, and select the Isolate command. Select this line and press Enter. Select this object and hit Delete on your keyboard. Right click the UCS and select the World option. Go to the Visual Style Control, click the 2D wireframe, and select the Realistic. Right click into the drawing area, Isolate, End Object Isolation. Go to the Home tab, Layer panel, and click the Unisolate command. Zoom in into this area. Now go to the visuals, go to the View Control, click and select the SA Isometric. Go to the Quick Access toolbar and click the Save button. All right, we're going to stop the video at this point. In the next tutorial, we'll start to model our roof. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue on this series or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.